Good evening, it's your standard time. If you're watching this, you're checking in. I'd like to talk about parenting. I'm going to put you all on the spot. First, a disclaimer. I do not have children. However, I have had contact with children. Limited. Though it may be. Excuse me. Kentucky allergies. And I have two fur babies. Now, before you start scoffing me, I understand that my love toward my fur babies, although it is very strong to me, is actually in comparison like a 1,000th of a percent compared to the love that you feel for your children or child. I understand that. And, you know, like you would do anything for them, I mean, I assume I would, you know, do anything for my fur babies, because they're very special to me and to keep me centered and whatnot. But I understand that having kids is a huge step up. I'm not denouncing that, and I'm not one of those guys that's always like, oh yeah, you got a new baby? Yeah, I got two dogs I love very much. I'm not that guy. I understand there's a difference. Now, the disclaimer is over with. Teach your freaking kids right. I'm tired of going to Walmart and having to dodge some, you know, four-year-old riding a bicycle that isn't even his, unattended, you know, down the hardware aisle with no parents or anything about, you know, watching this kid. I mean, there's an old saying that it takes a community to raise a child, or a village. It takes a village to raise a child. Well, Walmart's not your village. All right, and there could be some, you know, pretty sadistic and shit people in there that could have ill intentions, just, you know, chomping at the bit, waiting for some unintended kid to just come roaming around, you know, kicking a ball that's not even his through Walmart aisles. Now I'm just looking in the window. I am not in the house, per se, to hear and see everything that's going on. But for me, looking in the window, what I'm seeing is basically unequipped adults that had a kid, because who has planned kids now? You know, maybe 1%. That could be a statistic, or it could just be made up. It's for you to discover. Actually plan their children. Well, the rest of the people out there just, you know, were irresponsible. Or it's a medical miracle, or it's, you know, divine conception, immaculate conception, or a condom broke, or they were taking antibiotics with their birth control, even though you know better. Anyway, now, from what I've read, millennials are not so much breeding, like, you know, Xers and Yers and Zers or whatever. And in a way, that's a good thing to me, because I'm not crazy about kids. I don't dislike them, but I can only take them in limited quantities, kind of tequila. I like tequila, but if I have too much, I'm going to, you know, start feeling real shitty and grumpy. And you don't want to see a grumpy trapper man. What I'm trying to say, back to the point, is start taking responsibility for your children. Okay? They're your property. You own them until they're 18, and even then you may own them a while longer. Alright, teach them right. Teach them right from wrong. Break any cycles that you may have in your family, whether it be substance abuse, physical abuse, mental abuse, verbal abuse, or even, you know, things like racism, littering, and the biggest one, stupidity. You know, teach them to read a book instead of playing video games all the damn time. And yes, it may seem pretty arbitrary and contradictory for some schmuck who doesn't have a kid to tell you what you need to do with your kid. But like I said, just, you know, I'm just looking in the window and telling you what I'm seeing. there's more shit kids out there than there are good ones. And that's what I've seen. Alright, like I said, I've got two fur babies, and I have to take responsibility for them. So, I've taught them to not run after cars. I've taught them to not bite kids or other people, even if they're getting their little tails or ears, you know, yanked on a little bit. Or, you know, someone playing in their food, they don't get all aggressive. I've taught them right. They listen to me. They come when I call them. They sit when I tell them to sit. More often than not, they poop when I take them outside to poop. And that's what I consider good parenting. All right? You teaching your kid and disciplining your kid and, you know, making them understand right from wrong, you know, safe from danger, moral versus immoral, respect versus disrespect, that's your job. Okay? Whether or not you knowingly signed a contract to get knocked up, you perform the act. Okay? If I go out there and fight somebody and I kill them, I signed up for manslaughter, whether I like it or not, because I killed them. Good guy. You know what I'm saying? You had your little fun, whether it was 8 seconds or 8 hours. Kudos if it was 8 hours. And now this has happened. Own it. There's such a lack of accountability. And this goes for almost everything. There's such a lack of accountability, but so much so for children, and it's sad that you're not teaching them the right thing to do. You're either too scared that someone else is gonna have an opinion on how you're disciplining your child, or you don't know what you're doing and you need some lessons. I mean, read a book, Parenting for Dummies. Or you don't care, in which case you're a shit person. And now you've got some schmuck you don't even know, me, telling you what you need to do. And it shouldn't come to that. You know what I'm saying? I mean, common sense is an uncommon virtue, but we're talking about a human life here. And that human life is the future of our race. Okay? They're going to be our caretakers. They're going to be the people, you know, paying taxes to keep the elderly afloat with Social Security. You know, they're going to be our garbage men. They're going to be our senators, which, despite the pay, is the same thing to me. They're going to be the future. You know, the future is now. And that, you know, that 20 cc's of Dream Killer that caused this child or children is your responsibility. So own it. And I feel stupid for having to tell you this. But we need to get a grip. I mean, it's getting stupid. You know, just, and I sound old saying this, but these teenagers, they have zero respect for people. All they care about is themselves. They're all self-entitled. And I wouldn't trust one to mow my yard, let alone become a doctor and treat me if I have some sort of severe wound. How sad is that? So yeah, that's my spiel. Accountability. Be accountable for your children and yourself. You are, in their eyes, a leader. Okay? Leadership by example. What you do or don't do is what they're going to do or not do. All right? And I'm trying to sound judgmental. I'm simply trying to instill some sort of I guess, Kentucky common sense into you to wake you up that you're responsible for your children. Because a lot of you are not acting like it. All right? If you're really that much of a shit person, then you'd be better off adopting them out than, you know, creating a carbon copy of yourself to, you know, make the world a worse place than it is. Because it's the people that make the world what it is. It's people. And, you know, that's it. Yeah. I just wanted to share that because I've been having a lot of experiences lately where I see, you know, neglect, child abuse in the form of obesity and spoiledness, you know, no respect, no consideration, no politeness, no manners. I just see, you know, parents just not giving a shit. And maybe they did it one time, but then they were like, well, I can't control the little bastard, so I'm just going to let him do whatever he wants to do. Let's go to Walmart so it gets you out of my hair for 5 minutes. You know, come on. Wake up. Wake the fuck up. All right, that's a human being. A baby is a little man. Treat it like one. You know, treat it like a human being. We all deserve respect. But, you know, you being neglectful and hateful and putting out a shit example is not helping anything. And I believe everybody has good in them. It's just, you've got to make sure you keep people on a good path so they will remain good. And that's all I got to say about that. And if you have any, you know, hate towards me, or discontent, or animosities, I completely understand, and I don't blame you, because like I said, I don't have kids. I'm only describing what I'm seeing. And I'm not saying parenting is easy. I'm not saying kids are easy, and I'm not saying that, you know, you're a complete F-up, because maybe you're not. Maybe you're doing the best you can with what you got. But, you know, try and do better. It just pisses me off. I'm tired of it. So be kind to one another. Love one another. Raise your prodigy how you would want yourself to be raised, given the opportunity to do it again. How's that? Break cycles. You know, create good people, because you created a life. The least you can do is bring it up right, or as the best you can. And if you're watching this, you're checking in. Stop breathing.